The KMC Conquest BAC-5051E is a multi-port BACnet router full of integrated features. This compact router is powerful enough for heavy network traffic when permanently installed, yet small enough to be carried as a technician's service tool. In this video, we're discussing two easily confused setups, BBMD versus foreign devices. After logging into the BAC-5051E router, you can find the configuration options under the routing tab. Here under each IP port, you will find a drop-down menu with options including BBMD, foreign device, and pad. Let's take a look at what each of these settings mean and when to use each one. BACnet routers forward special broadcast messages that are sent by BACnet devices and other BACnet routers. These broadcast messages are used by other devices and routers mainly to discover one another and the operator workstation. If you use more than one BACnet router in your system, your routers are almost always connected on different IP subnets or networks. IP routers are used to connect IP, not BACnet, networks together. These IP routers block all broadcast messages, including BACnet ones. Though BACnet routers can forward broadcast messages, the IP routers do not. This lack of broadcast forwarding by IP routers prevents the BACnet routers and devices from discovering routers and devices on other BACnet networks. There are three ways to configure a BACnet router to work around this issue: BBMD, foreign device, and padding. In all three methods, BACnet routers encapsulate broadcast messages into unicast messages that IP routers will forward. This concept is called tunneling and has been done in the IT networking world for decades. There are many IP protocols that use a tunneling method to get from here to there on different subnets. The most commonly used BACnet tunneling method involves BACnet routers configured with the BBMD and foreign device functions. Since padding is rarely done, we will not discuss that one here. A BBMD, or a BACnet broadcast management device, is a BACnet router that tunnels all broadcast messages it receives to all the other BBMDs and foreign devices it knows within your system. When a BACnet router receives this message, it sends it out to all the directly connected networks as a normal BACnet broadcast message according to the specified destination. All devices in your interconnected BACnet network can eventually receive all broadcast messages, even from BACnet networks that live on different IP subnetworks. A foreign device is either a BACnet device or a BACnet router that is temporarily connected to a BBMD, allowing it to access the network through any internet connection. It has to register with a BBMD on its own subnetwork to receive forwarded broadcast messages, and it can request the message be broadcast by the BBMD on its behalf. By registering with the BBMD, the foreign device becomes a member on the BACnet IP network. It can talk with any BACnet device directly without registration, but will only receive broadcasts when successfully registered with the BBMD. There are pluses and minuses to each configuration. When compared to the foreign device, a BBMD does have a more complicated setup process. Since BBMDs are BACnet routers, all interconnected BBMDs must use the same BACnet network number. With BBMDs, essentially you are creating a BACnet network that only has BBMD devices on it. But since it is a BACnet network, it is required to have its own unique BACnet network number. All BBMDs on this same network need to be configured with this same unique network number, or they'll get confused trying to route messages. Since BBMDs tunnel broadcast messages as unicast messages, they communicate point-to-point with other BBMDs. When configuring a BBMD, you must create a table of all the other router BBMDs you want to be aware of. This table is usually manually configured and must match in all BBMDs you are interconnecting. This takes time and effort and does open up the possibility of human error. The upside of a foreign device is that the BBMD can be configured to automatically allow any foreign device to register with it. Thus, the foreign device only needs to be configured with its BBMD's IP address. There is no matching table involved. The downside of the foreign device is it has a limited time to be registered. This is called the time to live. The default time is usually 30 minutes, which means every 30 minutes, the foreign device must re-register with the BBMD. If it does not, and the time to live expires, the BBMD will no longer send broadcast messages to the foreign device. Also, if the BBMD that the foreign device is registered to goes down, the foreign device has no way of knowing this. Once the BBMD goes live again, it will not recognize the foreign device. Because of this, foreign device configuration is only recommended for short-term or temporary use. Our general rule of thumb when configuring the BAC-5051E router on a BACnet network is simple. For permanent connection, use the BBMD method. It may take a bit more time and effort, but this will pay off with fewer issues down the line. If the connection is temporary, the foreign device configuration should be fine. For more information about the BAC-5051E router, please check out our other videos in this playlist. And to learn more about any of the solutions from the building geniuses at KMC, visit us on the web at kmccontrols.com.